10 Cats does countdown. John Richardson, Sean Luck, Miles Jupp, Ashling B, Nick Helm, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to Editor of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, the average Brit knows about 50,000 words, but for some reason they can't remember any of them whilst playing along with Countdown. Americans call mathematics math, arguing that mathematics functions as a singular noun, so math should be singular too. But then again, they also call bums fanny, so what do they know? And the world record for the most swear words in a television programme is 201 in a half hour. And that's the last time Sean's getting invited on Loose Women. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson. John describes himself as a double-door checker, as he's paranoid his front door isn't locked. Don't worry, John. Pretty sure it's locked. You definitely locked it, right?
Don't start, because I wasn't the last one out today.
I'm sure it'll be fine. Can you smell gas? Did you lock the door, though, when you...
Well, no, I didn't, because she's still in and she's told me to stop locking the door when she's in.
Have you genuinely locked people in the house?
If she's asleep, I'll double-lock the door.
Anyway, if John switched off the stair lift, there's no way she can come down anyway.
And joining John tonight, it's Ashling B. Wonderful to have Ashling B with us tonight. Usually when Channel 4 feature a young Irish woman, she's wearing a dress like a Christmas tree and marrying a scrap metal dealer. Up against them this evening is Sean Locke. Sean's the kind of guy you'd want on your side in a fight, particularly if that fight was with John Richardson. And Sean's teammate this evening is Miles Jupp. Miles studied divinity at Edinburgh University, where he got an A, men. Last time you were on, Miles, you were, frankly, appalling. You were terrible at this game. Have you been practising? Have you got any better?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I was very scolded by what happened last time, and I went away and I thought to myself, you know, I can either focus on paying the mortgage and enabling my children to eat, or I could get really shit hot at a load of letters and numbers games that have no practical use in the real world. There was no... It was not a difficult decision.
Are you saying you've got better or not?
Let's not reveal that yet.
Yeah. OK. And how does it feel to be back? You happy to be back?
What a buzz already. Yeah.
How do you feel about having Miles on your team, Sean?
It's great. I mean, it's great to be back with one of life's winners.
Have you got a game plan?
Yeah. My game plan tonight is, you know, yeah, puzzles, quizzes and all that. But the most important thing is to bring a little ray of sunshine into somebody's miserable, lonely life. Doesn't matter how ill you are, how sad you are, how lonely you feel. If I can bring a little momentary light, a flicker of happiness into your dismal, bleak, endless misery...
If you want to cheer someone miserable up, just let John win.
Yeah. Let's see what
happens. Ashling, did I have Countdown in Ireland?
Yes. I've actually never watched Countdown before. Because I'm not a nerd! No, but I think I might be brilliant at it, and I think with John, I'm on the same team. I think we're with a really good chance of winning on this
team. Doesn't sound like we're on the same team with all your nerd chat.
I'm really excited to be on John's team. I think it's going to go really well. There's no I in genius.
Miles, Sean, have you got mascots?
Oh, yes.
What have you got?
Yeah, I've got... this is actually... It's been in the family for years. This is a... this
It's, I've had it since I was very young. My granddad gave me this. He was given it himself by a sort of wise woman in a souk in Northern Africa. And he says this, I don't know who this cheeky chappy is, but always bring you luck. I put this sewage on my desk when I did my GCSEs. It was there for all of them. About five general anaesthetics. Just always. It just
birth,
means.
Birth
just
of your children.
Yeah, just means. Yeah.
It looks like the photo sort of they'll put on Sean's coffin when he dies.
Sean, do you have a mascot?
I don't have a mascot. Instead, I've gone for a coping mechanism. When I lose, which I will lose, there's ways of dealing with it. You can get upset, you can go, oh, I'm no good at this. Or you can just blow all your troubles away. And a few bubbles can make you put a lot of things into perspective. Bollocking arses. Oh, there we go. And that I find quite soothing.
John, do you have a mascot?
He's managed to catch.
Caught two of his bubbles.
You caught two of his bubbles? Oh.
It died. Why does everything I touch die?
He held it too tightly around the neck.
Oh, OK, that was the real me for a minute then.
John, what have you got mascot-wise?
I've gone a different way this week. To incentivise myself to victory, I've actually been sponsored this week by my local curry house, Nando's. The sad story of Nando's is that they were there before Nando's, and Nando's actually set up next door, and it was Nando's that caught on. And so I feel really sorry for the guys at Nando's.
Nando's sounds great.
If I get any points from curry-related words, they'll give me a free curry this evening.
Well, best of luck with that. Aisling, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have brought a picture of my mammy. With me as a baby. My mother loves language and English, and she especially loves punctuation. She'll kind of throw it in anywhere, like she's mad for an inverted comma. So as you see here, it's myself and my mother, Irish, both wearing green, and on the back she has, Aisling and Helen, we were always proud to be Irish and loved wearing green. And she does it on my birthday card. She writes things like, happy birthday to my wonderful daughter. What do you mean, mother?
Did your mum used to be a jockey?
She did used to be a jockey,
yes. That's not a euphemism, that's like a real question.
No. Yeah, I was just a result of a ride that went too far.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner we've got Nick Helm. Nick is the thinking woman's comedian. If the woman in question is thinking, I wish that comedian would stop staring at me, he's creepy. How does it feel to be back, sitting next to Susie?
I don't know, Susie. How does it feel having me back?
It's all cool now, don't worry. It's fine, I'm fine, I'm over it.
Oh, good.
Are you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, if you're all right with it, that's fine then.
Have you learned any new words, Nick, since you were last on the show?
Yes, I've learnt a new word. It's a lovely word. Repudiation. Repudiation. Everyone eat repudiation.
Repudiation.
Yeah? It's nice, isn't it? It's nice. It's nice. It makes me feel good. I'm sure it makes me feel good. It's another word for rejection.
Rejection.
And with Nick, it's the lovely Susie Dent. Susie, you wrote a book about the origins of some English words. Do you have any favourites?
Oh, I did some great research in Scotland about a man called Andrew Carr. He was left-handed, and so he built this castle that was designed for left-handed soldiers so they would surprise the enemy. And so there are 150 terms for being left-handed in this small area in Scotland, and one of them is car-fisted. There are lots and lots of variations.
So what, a castle just for left-handed soldiers?
Yes.
That surely was a euphemism, was it, back in the day? This is just for the left-handed boys. OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel was really brainy at school. She got more A's than a Scouser trying to break up a fight. Rachel, you're a big Manchester United fan. What's more tense and exciting, watching Man U play or watching these guys play Countdown?
There's just no comparison. This is more like, I used to play Sunday League football and sometimes they had a beer at half-time. This kind of feels more like that.
Sorry. You used to play Sunday League football?
Yeah.
And used to have a pint at half-time?
We didn't do very well.
It sounds like, I mean, I've never really been interested in going to see the football before, but...
Yeah.
Now...
It wasn't as...
If you're interested in getting into football, you should go and watch Man United this year. It's really funny, they're shit.
OK, tonight, the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown commemorative plate. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing.
Can you put it in dishwasher?
That is dishwasher safe. OK, everyone, let's count down. Time for our first game. Sean and Miles, you get the first pick of the letters.
OK. Vowel.
E.
Vowel.
O.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
O.
Consonant.
H.
Consonant.
G.
Consonant. Please.
D.
If you may be so kind, I would like a consonant.
T.
And just for luck, I'll have a consonant.
P.
OK, for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. What have you got, John?
I have a 6.
OK. Miles?
7.
I have 6 and a 7. Sean, sure. What have you got?
You haven't got 7.
No, I've got an 8.
Well, the numbers round is not looking good.
It is a 7, it is a 7.
What's that?
It will all be revealed.
OK. I've got a 5.
You got a 5. OK. What's your 5, Ashley?
Oh, paged.
John, you're 6.
When I go for a curry, Jimmy.
Tell me more, John.
Sometimes I pop down Nando's, I have a curry, I don't know if I mentioned it. Some of the sauces are very thin, and usually I would like to have spooned my curry onto the plate, but sometimes I come out and I've had to have gooped it.
Gooped. Gooped, Susie.
Appropriately, it's just there as a noun meaning a stupid person.
Sean?
Well, I had a 5, and then I spotted a 6.
Gated is my 5, but, of course, you could have had goated. And you've been goated.
What's goated mean?
To be goated. When you're goated, when you...
In certain satanic rituals, there's a need to turn you into a goat, and then you go, we have goated him, we've turned him into a goat.
Nick, is that true of satanic ritual?
Yeah, that's true.
Thanks, Nick. Gonna play it by the rules. Check, are you? Gonna check if it's right. Boring. What a chicken risk. Why don't we just go, let's have a bit of fun. Put goated in. Leave her alone!
You can be be a goat, obviously. You can be a lecherous man if you're a goat, but also you can be a stupid person. But you can't goat somebody.
You can't be goated.
No.
What about if you're making love very vigorously, you say you go at it?
Miles, 1 from 7.
My word, it was photoed.
Ah, very good. That's brilliant.
Photoed?
Photoed, yeah.
Doesn't sound right.
It's sort of old-fashioned.
I was photoed.
It's old-fashioned?
Yeah.
Amazing that Miles got that.
Done.
So, 7 points for Miles there. Right. Nick, Susie, what could they have done?
They could have had pothead. But they missed it.
Pothead. Numbers round. OK, John, Aisling, your turn to pick the numbers.
What do you think?
We'd pick two big ones, don't we?
Two big ones two and big ones. Four little ones.
Yeah.
Two big ones chosen.
Two mains and four sides.
All of these should be on the takeaway menu if you want to count it.
Excellent.
Number 10.
Yeah.
Garlic naan.
Number 6.
Pilau rice.
Number 5.
Aloo Gilby.
Number 9.
Sag aloo.
Number 50.
Oh, chicken korma lamb jalfrezi.
7:12, the target. Your time starts now. John, did you get it?
I got 715.
715, OK. Aisling, how'd you do?
679.
Lovely having you here. Miles?
711.
Sean?
715.
Miles? 711. How'd you get it?
Oh... 50 plus 25 is 75, am I right?
50 plus 25, yeah, 75.
Yeah. So what I've done is I've times that by 10.
For 750.
750, and then I times 5 by 6, and that's 30.
Yep.
I subtract that from 750, and then I take off the 9, and that gives me 711.
Yeah, very good, one away.
So 7 points to Miles. Rachel, could it have been done?
No, this one's impossible. But one away is a good effort.
Wait, no, so it's not always possible to get to the number at the top?
No.
Who's in there behind? Just a man swinging them around?
It's just a random number generator and they're just tiles, so some of them are impossible.
I thought it was done by a computer.
Yeah, that really looks like a computer.
So at the end of that, John and Aisling have no points, Sean and Miles have 14. OK, time to go across the dictionary corner. Nick, what have you got for us?
Well, I was going to just... pick a poem out of my poetry book and then just read your poem.
That sounds good, OK. Just at random?
Just randomly. Oh, this one will do. Everything was wonderful. Everything was great. Everything was perfect. Then it turned to hate. The clouds, they started forming. Now she doesn't take my calls. She pretends that nothing happened, that she's better than it all. Well, sorry, I'm still breathing. Excuse me for sitting here. Didn't realise my presence would cause you such a stir. Am I just a piece of used meat, chewed up and spat out in the cold, sitting here beside me, judging? And that is a poem called Sitting Next to the One That Broke My Heart on Countdown.
Very nice. And here's your teaser. The words are light suck, and the clue is you'll be very fortunate. That's light suck. You'll be very fortunate. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were light suck, and the clue was you'll be very fortunate. It was, of course, luckiest. So, Sean and Miles are in the lead. OK, for this round only, it's Sean against Aisling. Aisling, your turn to choose.
Could I get a vowel, please?
Of course.
Rachel?
E.
Could I get another vowel, please?
A.
Can I get a consonant, please?
R.
Oh! Oh!
All right, looks like my luck's coming in.
Now, can I get...
No, can you have? Can you have? You can't say get.
Can I...
Because Rachel's getting them. You can't get it, because she's got them.
All right, Professor Riggins, I'm learning me English slowly but surely. May I please have a vowel, please, Rachel?
You may.
That's better.
Thank you.
I.
And another consonant.
If it's an N.
D.
Oh.
Could I get a T? Oh, another vowel, please.
A.
And a consonant. I can't get any more vowels, can I?
You can have one more, I think.
Oh, can I have one more?
Yeah, you can have one more. Go crazy.
No, do you know what? I'm going to stay sane and get two more consonants, please.
S and Z.
OK, your time starts now. OK, what have you got?
I think I've got seven, you know.
Hmm. Well, what have you got?
I've got six.
What's your six?
Snared.
Good.
Sandier.
Susie, can she have Sandia?
She definitely can. Brilliant.
Oh, brilliant.
7 points, Aisling.
Sometimes after a really satisfying letters game, I like a small chocolate. Just a little square chocolate.
Looks delicious, John.
You're welcome. Don't thank me. Thank the guys at Nando.
I'm just gonna have one more bit. I've got a really crusty bit. It's delicious.
Do you know how to make a good apple pie? My Nando's.
Could that be any better?
Sardine.
Same, seven.
Okay. So at the end of that, John and Aisling have seven, Sean and Miles have 14. Time now for John and Miles to go head-to-head. Miles, your turn to pick the numbers.
Would you mind awfully acquiring me a big number?
And five little ones.
Yeah, why not?
Right, five small ones. Three, seven, ten, five and one, and the large one, 25. Ooh. And the target, 190.
OK, let's see if Rachel can do this. Your time starts now. Pressure's on, Rachel. Pressure is on. Yes, it is. No. What have you got there? Is that a hot towel?
Honestly, I couldn't manage another number.
What did you get there, John?
190.
Miles?
I got 188.
John, how did you do it?
25 minus 5 minus 1.
It's 19.
Times by 10.
190.
10 points to John. OK, so Sean and Miles have 14, John and Aisling have 17. Yeah. Time to go across now to what looks like a slightly frosty dictionary corner. What have you got for us, Nick?
You just don't get it, Susie. Let me spell it out to you. Let me add it up. Let me put it in your book so you can look it up. I just dreamed up with Up Susie. We'll pick a different word. You can say it any way you like, any way you heard. Susie, Susie, don't you see? You belong with a man like me. I write you fucking poetry every single night. With your nimble fingers, skip right from A to Z. You can spell it every way you want if you spell it in your head. Oh, you can count on me. You can count on me. You can count every way you want in your dictionary. You can count on me. You can count on me. You can spell it any way you choose, hypothetically. You sometimes leave me speechless. Can't even say a word. Can't even say a consonant. Can't even say a verb. One and one makes two. I'm in love with you. Two and one makes three. If you're in love with me, you can count on me. From A to Z. A, I love you, girl. B, cause you rock my world. C, cause you rock my world. D, don't you know you rock my world. E, etc. X, xylophone. Y, yeah, xylophone. Z, zebras. You can count on me. You can count on me. You can spell it any way you choose. In your dictionary. Count on me, you can count on me. You can spell it any way you choose. You can count on me.
Susie, do you think you'd be able to count on Nick?
Consider me thawed.
The score for the moment, Sean and Miles are on 14, John and Aisling are on 17. And here is your teaser. The words are sad Miles. And the clue is, I gave him the wrong impression. That sad Miles, I gave him the wrong impression. See you after the break. The words were sad Miles, and the clue was, I gave him the wrong impression. It was, of course, Miss Leeds. OK, before we move on, it's time to welcome the man recently promoted to Countdown's official stuntman. It's Joe Wilkinson!
Yep. New Countdown stuntman, so pretty. What the fuck was that? That wasn't planned, you mental case.
Joe, why do we at Countdown need a stuntman?
I don't have a go, Jimmy, but you've seen the show, not like it happens. You just sit around, it's like an old people's home. So I've asked me to sort of, you know, jazz it up a little bit, give it a bit of razzmatazz. Yeah, I'll eat that later. So I've got some ideas, some, you know, a bit of drama. Like, I thought I could, Whoa. Right, we're not doing that then. Sword swallowing. You just open your mouth, I'll just jam it down. No, fine, this is like, what is the point? You could bang your head on a breeze box till you black out. It's like you want this show to fail, mate.
I'm just saying those...
If you're not going to do anything, all right, at the end of the show, rather than that, like, conundrum bollocks, I've agreed to be shot out of a cannon. That's why.
Have you got a cannon?
I knew there was something. Do it your way, fuck it.
OK, Sean and Miles, your turn to choose the letters.
Consonant, please. Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
G.
And a vowel.
E.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
Last one. I.
Is that all of them?
That's all of them.
I better write them down.
Your time starts now. OK. Aisling?
I also have a 4.
Miles?
5.
Sean?
5.
OK, what's your 4, John?
Well, Jimmy, sometimes you go for a curry and a naan bread. It's just too much. And you think, I'll just have a roti. Just have a little roti. I mean, yes, we may lose the game, but that's another free curry.
Your 4, Aisling?
I got a gate, as in G-A-I-T. Like your gate.
Like your walk, yes.
Sean, your 5?
Pager.
OK, Miles?
Tiger. Tiger.
5 points to Sean and Miles. Susie, Nick, could they have done any better?
Yeah, they could, couldn't they?
They could.
Yeah.
Go for it. You go.
No, you do it.
No, you go. Honestly, you do it.
Oh, you do it.
You could have a potager, which is...
A potager?
A kitchen garden.
Kitchen garden.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Miles are in the lead with 19 points. Round. OK, John and Aisling to pick the numbers.
Can I get you to get me two big numbers again?
Two big,
Rachel.
Four little ones.
Yes, please.
Are you going to help out with this?
No, I might learn the harp. Thanks, guys. Sorry if you put clothes on, but, you know. You do your thing, you live your lives.
Do you think you could play while I read out the numbers?
Yeah, well, I'm new to it, so...
All right, well, I'll just... You start and I'll go.
No, it's actually a piece of piss.
Hang on, I'm just... I don't know about you, but I'm just remembering a countdown show we did years ago.
It would be hard.
10, 5, 8.
It's like an early 75. Oasis song.
And the target, 342.
Your time starts now.
Okay.
target was 3-4-2. How did you do, Aisling?
I got...
John, how did you do?
Oh, bollocks. I got 340.
OK. Miles?
340.
Me too.
340 as well. Aisling?
339.
339. You definitely got that within the time as well, yeah?
Yes, I actually did, though. I tried to cheat a bit longer, but it didn't work. 339.
Miles, how did you get 340?
50 times 6 and 5 times 8.
50 times 6 for 300 and 5 times 8 for 40, for 340.
John, how did you do it?
Oh, well, I mean, his is better. 75 plus 10 is 85.
85.
50 over 5 is 10. Minus the 6 is 4.
Minus the 6 is 4.
And then I times them.
Yeah, 340.
So 7 points to both teams. Rachel, could that be done? 342?
Yep. 75 minus 10 minus 8 is 57.
Oh, and she's back. She's six. Back. This is the Rachel I know and love. 57 times 6?
Yep, 342.
That could be bullshit. We don't know.
There's no way of checking. That's the shame of it. So the scores at the moment, John and Aisling have 24, Sean and Miles have 26, pretty close. And here is your final teaser. The words are Helm's bit, and the clue is, it's the size of a fingertip. That's Helm's bit, it's the size of a fingertip. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were Helm's bit. The clue was, it's the size of a fingertip. It was, of course, Fimbles. OK, time for our final letters game. Aisling, your turn to choose.
Oh. Can I have a vowel, please?
You can indeed.
O. Another vowel, please.
E.
Yeah. And then a consonant.
G.
G.
Oh! That noise means, Aisling, you get a bonus round! Now, is you have a chance to win your team 6 points.
Oh!
What will happen is you will find a bag next to your seat. In that bag are some knives. What you have to do is throw the knives at this board. Every time one of those knives stick in the board, you win your team a point. But every time a knife sticks in me, you lose a point. It's as simple as that. So can we drop the lights a little?
I might take
okay.
cover.
Pop out the way, love. This shit's happening. OK, take the knives out of the bag.
Oh, Joe, there's only plastic forks in here.
Does no one read the fucking emails?
I was really excited. I thought that was going to be brilliant. OK, back to the game. Aisling, pick a letter.
Can I get a vowel?
No,
please?
You can't.
I.
Can't.
Oh, Sean!
Can I please have a consonant?
S.
R. And another R, yeah, and then...
D.
A D. Yeah, I'll give it a go. another consonant.
L.
L, and then one more vowel.
And the last one. A.
Yeah.
Your time starts now. John, how many have you got?
Seven.
Seven. Aisling?
Five.
Five. Miles?
Five.
Sean?
Five.
Miles, what's your five?
Rails.
Rails. Sean?
Aegis. A-E-G-I-S.
Aisling, your five?
Large.
John, your seven?
Gliders.
Gliders. Seven points for John and Aisling.
That hurt, that one.
Sean's taking it well. Nick, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, they could have. They could have got an eight. Or they could have got a six. They could have had orgies.
Orgies was up there. Of course it was. Susie?
They could have had darioles for eight, which are cooking pots. They're kind of flower pot shaped, but you might be able to get a curry in. But it's there for eight anyway.
OK, so Sean and Miles have 26. John and Aisling are just in the lead with 31 as we go into the final numbers game. OK, Sean, Miles, your turn to pick the numbers.
No, sorry, two big ones and four little ones, please.
Two large, four small. Right, this round is 10, 8, 9...
Is there a number called 17, or did I make that up?
Add those two, you get it. 25, 75, 6, 7, 7.
OK, your time starts now. Get it down yet. A little bit of chat you wouldn't go out and miss right about now, I'd say. Well, how was that audition as Cookie Monster? Okay, what have you got, John?
677!
You got 677.
Watch out for those storm clouds, cos here comes Rain Man. That's amazing, John.
Ashley, what have you got?
625.
OK, Sean, what have you got?
I got 678.
678, OK, Miles?
675.
675, OK. John, how'd you do it?
75 times 9.
75 times what?
9.
It's 675. Did that in my head, whatever.
Ten. I couldn't get the two. I did 6, 9 times 75 is 675. I couldn't get the 10 minus 8. Just didn't see it. It's the panic.
10 points to John. Possibly the greatest machine that's ever been invented.
I find it in really tough moments, it really helps. They're my bubbles. Actually, I can't turn it off.
OK, no, fine.
Quite a lot of liquid around electrics now.
OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Sean?
A weast saw. You know what a weast saw?
That's not it. Restart the clock. John, did you just buzz?
I buzz like a man who's just eaten a hot curry and has got a bit of a cob on and finds himself the sweatiest man in the room. Is it sweatiest?
Let's have a look.
Very good.
Sweatiest. So we've got it. So the final scores are Sean and Miles have 26, but tonight's winners with 51, John and Aisling. Congratulations, you two. You are now the proud owners of a Countdown commemorative plate. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Sunday, the street racers are on for a massive heist. Vin Diesel, The Rock, gets Speedy in the network premiere of Fast Five, Sunday at 9. But coming up, tricking Katy Perry and Ricky Gervais like a good'un, it's David Blaine...